Hello, welcome to my channel. And in our previous video, in data structure, we discuss about algorithm, analysis of algorithm, time complexity, space complexity, and with the example of pizza, I explained you time and space complexity. For this, you can refer to my previous video based on space complexity and time complexity. In this video, we will discuss about the asymptotic notations. The students are confused in between asymptotic notation and asymptotic analysis. So these are two different things. In asymptotic analysis, we use asymptotic notations. So if you're answering the question about asymptotic analysis, so you have to explain about asymptotic analysis, why we are doing, and then asymptotic notation come explained in asymptotic analysis. So in this question, we are using asymptotic notations. And the question is, describe asymptotic notation in detail. So asymptotic notation, what is it? We must instead concentrate on proportionality approach, expressing the complexity in terms of its relationship to some known function. This type of analysis is known as asymptotic analysis. So now asymptotic notation are used in asymptotic analysis. So when we are doing any programming or coding, before that we write some algorithm. So for the algorithm, we have to first analyze which type of algorithm it is. Is it taking a more time, or is it taking a less time, or how much space or memory it is taking. So the analysis or checking the complexity of algorithm, we use asymptotic notations, so that we can divide this in two parts, three parts: best case, average case, and worst case. And the notation, three notation we are using here: big O, omega, and theta notation. So let's go to the definition. Asymptotic notation are languages that allow us to analyze an algorithm running time by identifying its behavior as the input size of the algorithm increases. जिस तरीके से the input size increase होता है, when input size increases, so this is no when it increases, algorithm increases. So this is known as algorithm growth rate. So I already told you about the best case, worst case, and average case. So asymptotic notation gives us the ability to answer these questions. So here is another definition. Asymptotic notation are expressions that are used to represent the complexity of an algorithm. Average case, in which we analyze the performance algorithm for the input, for which the algorithm takes time or space that lies between best and worst case. For when you writing any algorithm or any coding, the worst case is very important. When we know about the worst case, so we know that our algorithm don't go beyond the worst case. It's a limitation. So if we know about what bad can be happen, so then we can do our best and prepare for bad situations also. So same is here. So when we are analyzing the algorithm, asymptotic notations are used. So these are three. So let us see in detail. Here is another definition. Asymptotic analysis of an algorithm refers to the defining the mathematical foundation framing of its runtime performance. Using asymptotic analysis, we can very conclude the best case, average case, and worst case scenario of an algorithm. In exam, the question came 10 marks or 20 marks. So you have to describe everything here. Asymptotic analysis is input bound. If there is no input to the algorithm, it is continued to work in a constant time. If there is no input, so we will conclude to work as a constant time, fixed. Other than the input, all the other factors considered constants. Input ke alawa, sare factors jo hai wo constant hote hain. तो चेंज नहीं होते. एसिम्प्टोटिक एनालिसिस रेफर्स टू द कंप्यूटिंग द रनिंग टाइम ऑफ एनी ऑपरेशन इन मैथमेटिकल यूनिट्स ऑफ कंप्यूटेशन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, हियर इज एग्जाम्पल, द रनिंग टाइम ऑफ वन ऑपरेशन इज कंप्यूटेड एज एफ ऑफ एन एंड मे बी फॉर अनदर ऑपरेशन इट इज कंप्यूटेड एज जी एन जी ऑफ एन स्क्वायर. दिस मीन्स दैट द फर्स्ट ऑपरेशन रनिंग टाइम विल इंक्रीज लिनियरली विद द इंक्रीज इन एन. सो द रनिंग टाइम ऑफ द सेकेंड ऑपरेशन विल इंक्रीज एक्सपोनेंशियली व्हेन एन इंक्रीजेस. So similarly, the running time of both operation will be nearly the same if n is significantly increases, significantly small. So here is n is the input. Usually, the time required for algorithm fall under three types: best case, average case, and worst case. In our last video, I already told you about that the time complexity is very important for any algorithm. So minimum time required for the program execution, for the programmer's to increase the programmer's productivity, we have to analyze the algorithm so that in minimum time or less memory we can execute our program. So best case is where minimum time required for program execution, and average case is average time required for program execution, and worst case is maximum time required for the program execution. So here is the asymptotic notation, you already seen in the slides. So let's see big O notation. The notation ON is the formal, O of N is the formal way to express the upper bound of an algorithm. So it's a upper bound of running time, measures worst time complexity of the longest amount of time an algorithm can possibly take to complete. So upper bound is it measures a worst case complexity or the longest amount of time. Here is the longest amount of time algorithm can possibly take to complete. Here the worst case, maximum time required for execution. So you can relate big O with worst case. Here is f of n and g of n. So g of n is above f of n. Here is the notation. Here is for the function f of n, here is g of n, there exists c is greater than 0 or n 0 such that f of n is less than this. Okay, so you can see here the equation. Omega notation. The omega notation is the formal way to express the lower bound of an algorithm running time. It is the opposite of upper bound. It measures the best time complexity or the best amount of time an algorithm can possibly take to complete. Here is the f of n is above g of n. So if f of n is more than g of n, then the best case. If f of n is below g of n in the graph, so you can say that the worst case. For example, for f of n, omega f of n is greater than equal to g of n, there exists c is greater than 0, and this equation you can see here. Theta notation. And the notation theta n is the formal way to express both the lower bound and upper bound of an algorithm running time. It represents as follows. F of n is between g of n. So it's a average case. So you can see here equation. So In this video, we discussed about the asymptotic notation.